Anoint this room right now, Father God, with the blood of Jesus. Pray that the Spirit moves, Father God. And that you speak through me, Father God. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
Well, tonight, fellas, I got this message when we watched Blessed and Cursed. Part of the movie. The bishop's son, he was taken up after his father. You know, his father was making him be, you know, like third or second in the church, and that's not what his passion, that's not what he was, you know, felt led to do. He could sing, and he had a beautiful voice, but his father wanted him to take part in what he was doing. He wanted the legacy to live through him, but he could sing, and he never had time to fulfill what God had blessed him with. You know, and someone told him, the main character told him, you can't do, you know, what your father wants you to do. You got to do what God wants you to do. And so the message today is, we can't do what society wants us to do. We have to do what God wants us to do.
You have to obey your father. It's in the Bible. You obey your parents. One of the commandments.
Praise God. So society wants us to fail. You know what I'm saying? Us being convicted felons and not, you know, them not giving us a chance. They expect us to fail because of our past. But little do they know that they are in prison or have been in prison within themselves. They don't know what they're truly battling. And the Bible says in Ephesians 6:12, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. What they don't realize is that we are new creations. You look up 2 Corinthians 5:17 for me, brother. We're new creations. God created us in his image. And when we accept our salvation in the blood of Jesus Christ, we become new.
2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new.
The old man is gone. The past is gone. The Lord has forgotten the past. Only we hold on to it, you know. We dwell in the past and bring up that. And that's where our burdens come, because we can't let that go. We can't forgive ourselves for the past. But the Lord is looking forward. He's looking at what he created you for. The destiny that he has chosen for you already.
Yeah, I've seen him. You want to comment, not only dwell on the past, but actually glorify the past crimes, like you're bragging about it, like it was a good thing.
Philippians 1:13. So we're no longer bound by the things of this world when we accept the blood of Jesus Christ, our salvation. The precious blood of Jesus Christ. Paul said that he was in chains for Christ in Philippians 1:13.
So that my bonds in Christ are manifested in all the palace and in all other places.
Mine reads, NIV says, as Philippians 1:13, right? Amen. It says, as a result, it has come clear throughout the whole palace guard and to everyone else that I am in chains for Christ. You know, us Christians being in prison at this time, you know, people don't accept our walk. They don't accept our faith. A lot of them don't. They think that we're just jailhouse preachers or jailhouse religion. Mm-hmm. That it's not ever going to work, you know, once we get out. But look at Paul's outlook on it. You know, he was in jail, in prison for Christ. Can we turn our situation and look at it as a positive thing and take the ridicule as fire? You know, because the Lord says that they will hate you because of my name. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I don't know where that's located, but...
Gotcha.
Yeah.
I gotcha.
Amen. You know, so... Our parents, our friends, our peers may pressure us to make decisions in our life. You know?
Amen.
They may be looking at what's best for you in their eyes.
Amen.
You know? And we as judgmental people, you know, take heed to their outlook because, you know, we respect them and we love them, you know, and we don't want to hurt their feelings most of the time. But do we really look at, you know, putting God in our equation and putting Him first? What is going to be, what is best for the kingdom of the Lord? What is best for the kingdom of God? When do we take that draw and actually stand back and say, and stand up and say, you know what? I love you, Mom. I love you, Dad. But, you know, the Lord has spoken clearly to me. And this is what I feel that I need to do. And stand by what the Lord has told you to do.
Well, think about when Christ called his disciples. They didn't have time to think about what they were going to do.
Amen.
And he said, he says, I'm a fisherman.
Come.
Well, I'll make you a fisherman of men. Come right now.
Come follow me. And he just kept walking. Either they dropped what they did and followed him, or they kept doing what they were
doing. Remember the other one he said? Let the dead bury the dead.
Mm-hmm.
Because he said, I got a funeral to go to. No, let the dead bury the dead. When Christ calls you, you have to answer. He's the highest authority.
Where's that located, brother?
In John 17:14.
Why don't you read it?
I have given them thy word, and the world hath hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world.
Mm. They will hate you for my name's sake. That's powerful. And you know, we get sized every day, you know, because we're a light, and people see that Jesus is in our smile and in our walk and the hope that we have, you know, so we stand out. We're the light of the world, and people watch us under a microscope. Every little fault that we do, they use it against us. Oh, look at him. He's a Christian man, but look what he's doing. You know, and it hurts sometimes because it's... Because
they don't look for faults. They don't look for good things. They look for bad things. Mm-hmm. You know?
But we're not perfect, you know?
No.
And the Lord says, like he just read, they will hate you for my name's sake, because we feel the love. We show the love. Mm-hmm. Amen. So, what gift did God give to you to benefit the kingdom of God? Unlock the fruits of the Spirit that God has rooted in your life by obeying the Lord. He will reveal these gifts to you. The apostles told the authorities in Acts 5:29, we must obey God rather than men. We must obey God and trust in His word. Samuel told Saul in 1 Samuel 15:22. We're talking about this today, Brother Cam. Mm-hmm. It was 15:22. To obey is better than sacrifice. What does this mean? Let scripture back up that. Mark 12:33. You look that up for me, Bagnell?
Uh-huh.
Mark 12:33.